So it's either 2:30 in the morning, or 2:15 in the morning, or 1:15 in the morning, or 3:15 in the morning, and 1:15. It's the middle of the damn night, isn't it? And I was just kind of thinking about how people who don't understand where I'm coming from, just as a man, as a human being, could easily get the wrong impression. About my confidence and my adamancy regarding how full of shit most people on YouTube are, most news and whatnot channels, even places like Seeker Daily and like just things claiming to be information sources that are just twisting your mind and neutering your defenses. And the reason why I feel this way it's because of Barack Obama, in a nutshell. It's because of my path leading up to Barack Obama. Because from a certain perspective, and this is why it's gonna, I'm really, really just gonna feel like a hole is missing in my life. If Hillary disappoints, which I don't know where the bar is, but if Hillary disappoints, it's just gonna be even more heartbreaking. Because for me, Obama represents a victory that took me like my whole life, man. I mean, really, like, I lived out a struggle between rich and poor and a struggle between white and black. I lived out America's plight in this microcosm of unmanageable stress. I went from living in Alabama and Houston to living in New Zealand and Australia and coming back to having my parents getting divorced and then basically just going from one ghetto to another. My mom relied on a lot of different men, should I say, and I had to deal with a few of them. And I lived in areas where, like you weren't allowed to be white, but I lived there. And there ain't a lot of areas like that, and like in Donald Trump's mind, there are, there's not a lot like that anymore. Because, now, if a white person goes to the ghetto, they're probably trying to buy their drugs. See, I was in the hood, I'd be laughing at it all the time. I'd be sitting up on my steps, just watching. A little white girl come here. Where's she going? Been there about 5 minutes. Come back out. And people, cops pull us over, asking us why we were there. I'm like, we live there. And they're like, why? Then, like, and that phased into my life of, going to New Orleans and trying to grow out of having like a gangster type mentality, led me into being a very spiritual person, and even considered converting to Islam around the time that Oz was on HBO. because it just seemed like those guys were acting more Christian than the people I knew. And at the time, I was dealing with a crisis of faith from observing my, well, not my peers, but just like my family and people around me. And it seemed like the rich people in my family who considered themselves the most Christian, the holier than thou types, were just the most greedy, heartless fucking people. And, you know, now we call those people Republicans. And I've learned that. And I went through just a whole long time just raging against my dad because he was one of these people. And, you know, he all but just kind of, you know, lost interest, should I say. And it became a big chip on my shoulder, feeling like his money was worth more than his child, okay? And I could see this pattern in so many people where their money was worth more than their honor, was worth more than their faith, was worth more than their country. And then George Bush got elected. George Bush Jr. W. And I wasn't too happy. But I was like, whatever. I had bigger fish to fry. I wound up, you know, it was right after I hurt my back. And I had moved to South Dakota because I lost my job. And, well, that's just not a story worth going into. But yeah, South Dakota's pretty. And then I woke up one morning feeling like an I-beam, like a plank, just like was going through my chest and I was falling downwards. And like I kind of felt like my soul was kind of coming back up through my bed into my body when I woke up out of bed. Okay. And I had the news on. I was actually running a just kind of like a up-to-date kind of thing on like what's going on in the political world. I think at the time it was like, it seemed to me like just weird shit was happening. I don't know if I had started my news list yet at that point, but I was like the friend that kept other friends informed. But anyways, for some reason or another, I had two TVs going already at that point. One of them on CNN and one of them on MSNBC. And I looked up, and that was right after the first plane hit. And, the diagonal motion of the beam suddenly kind of just seemed to make a horrifying amount of sense. And my first thought was I knew the fucking Cold War wasn't over. But then, like, the brainwashing kicked in, you know? Oh, that's silly. And then I heard, oh, Vladimir Putin was the first person to call. And I'm like, oh, that's a little fucking suspicious. But okay, I'll let you tell me what to think about that. Didn't you let them tell you what to think about that? But then Bush just seemed like he was hiding something. And Dick Cheney really seemed like he was hiding something. And even when Bush tried to turn away from Dick Cheney shot his lawyer in the face. That was Bush's lawyer, by the way. Bush's trusted family lawyer. The only personal lawyer, non-business related lawyer W would have had. Non-politics, just his personal family lawyer from back in fucking Houston, I'm pretty sure. I got shot in the face by Dick Cheney. This is right after the Pelosi leverage situation, in which I believe it came out that Vladimir Putin had been playing us. Okay. Now, during this whole time period, I was in and out of homelessness because I was from 9/12 on a political activist, just full tilt. And I had a friend who put a tracker on my email bulletin because I had it just a copy paste email list, and then I had people would send that out to other people, and the tracker came back that I was reaching 65,000 people with my little newsletter. And that was pretty cool. This was back in 2002, you know. Being politically active at that point was really difficult. The government was out to get you at that point because there was some weird shit going on. And it was a hell of a struggle. I mean, I was in and out of homelessness, usually due to weird circumstances with bills. Like I would have to call them, give them my phone number, give them my email address over again. Like my accounts kept on getting screwed up almost every single month. And it was just a painstaking, almost decades long struggle. A rage against the machine that I had to live out. Okay. And when Barack Obama got elected, it was like victory, you know? It really was. It was a personal, deeply, deeply personal victory. Me. After all the shit that I'd seen, after all the shit that I'd been through, it felt like I had spent my life trying to get this man elected. And then these fucking people came out of the woodwork, organized by Dick Army. Army of dicks. And they started talking about the elites and the Illuminati and conspiracy. I'm like, who the fuck are you people? And where the fuck have you been in the past 10 years during which we were under the command of a fucking basic tyrant? Called George W. Bush. And now you fuckers want to show up and spoil my victory? And spoil America's victory? Because that's what they did. They just sapped it right out. Now, here we are. Shame on us. We're letting them spoil another one. We're ignoring so much. And for what? I mean, it can't just be for the sake of false equivalency. It really seems to me like people don't know what an insane, terrifying threat Vladimir Putin is. And just the possibility, just the slightest possibility that Donald Trump could be working with or for him, even unwittingly. I've been warning this audience, whoever's been watching these videos, I've been warning about exactly this happening here since way back when it would have sounded ridiculous. Now it doesn't sound so ridiculous, but you gotta take what I've been saying into context to understand exactly how real this is. I'm no fucking amateur. I've been doing this for a long time. And I never made any assumptions. I never assumed anything was known that wasn't known about George W. Bush. You know, I don't even do that about myself, okay? Which, true. It's kind of hard to fathom when you really think about it. Yeah, I guess that's what I'm gonna call this video. The struggle is real. These fucking people are fake. And if you can respect that, I hope you can empty your cup and actually learn what's really going on in the world. Because I had to do the same thing. I'm not asking anyone. I've never asked anyone throughout my many thousands of years of existence. Never asked anyone to do something that I haven't already done. You gotta empty your cup. Let all that paranoia go. And be willing to heal your American patriotism. Be willing to heal your American spirit. And it comes easy once you decide that. It comes easy once you realize you can forgive your country and love it again. This wasn't something we did to ourselves. And some of the biggest jerks out there, all they need is a little truth, not just love. Thanks for listening to Maya. Y'all take it easy.